Aboriginal people, men and women, played a vital part in the Australian overlanding epics. Their intimate knowledge of the land made them invaluable workers. Their songs at night always seemed the most suitable to settle mobs of cattle, and their humour has had an influence on frontier life not generally acknowledged.
Three old Aboriginal drovers. The first was aged 70.
When I'm young fella, drover, work for Mr. Kidman, Mr. Sidney Kidman. We would start one time, Kimberley country, Windham. We got a big mob of store bullock, and we start walk. All right, we walk, Windham, VRD, Top Spring, Meringer Track Dry Stage, Newcastle Water, Barkley Table and more further, Lake Nash. And we sell him bullock there in the Queensland, Urundanji.
And the second old bloke was 80.
Oh, that nothing. When I'm young boy, drove for old Nat Buchanan, old Paraway. Bit of Buchanan, we got a big mob of store bullock there, Gulf Country, Normanton. And we start walk. All right, we walk. Normanton, Cloncurry, this before Mount Isa, Bullia, Paduri, Birdsville, Dry Stage, Birdsville Track, right through, Marie, Peterborough, and we, Middlepala Paraway, we sell him bullock there in Adelaide.
And the third old bloke was 90. Bit shaky on his pins, but a wise old man.
Oh, that nothing. When I'm young fella, drover for Mr. Tyson, Mr. Hungry Tyson. We wouldn't start one time. We got a biggest mama bullock in the world. And we start walk. All right, we walk and we start in the Australia. And we walk. Oh, goodness, we walk right up in the Hengland.
And the other two looked at one another and one said,
Hey, hang on, old fellow. He said, hang on. He said, you can't take him bullock from the Australia into the Hengland. He said, are you going to crush that salt water?
Oh, no problem, my boy. No problem. We've been walk along the beach.